Welcome back to my channel. Hello everyone. We are still busy with this question paper for November 2021. And on a previous video, I was looking at the debit notes, the return to the suppliers, where we returned to Pretty Woman. Now I'm going to talk about the supplier journal where we buy the non-stock items. We saw that we had three invoices on page 10 to 11. It was Pretty Woman, and then it was CompuWorld, and it was Amali Suppliers. Pretty Woman and Amali Suppliers, we were buying stock on those suppliers, and we recorded those transactions in the supplier invoice. So we didn't record CompuWorld. So now I'm going to talk about CompuWorld, and we said, with CompuWorld, we are buying non-stock item, and the non-stock item are going to be processed through the journal. In this case, the journal will be the supplier journal. So I'm going to open my supplier journal. Then the first thing that I do when I arrive here is to go to the settings. So I don't need to put the opening balance. Remember, we did this supplier journal when we're doing the take on balances. So that is why the account 9999 is still activated here. So we need to remove it. How do we remove it? You can just put the zeros and then press tab on your keyboard. This account will be removed. Why am I removing it? It's because each and every line that I'm going to record here is going to have its own contra account. So that's why I have to remove this 9990. Then we are now processing for the current year. So it means I'm going to leave this year's processing. And then remember, this business is a VAT vendor. So we need to charge VAT. So we must activate VAT. And then we must activate the default tax type, which is 01, the VAT at a standard rate of 15%. We must also check whether the invoice is exclusive or inclusive. So if you can check on page 10 there, you will see that this invoice is inclusive. So it means we must activate inclusive there. We must activate inclusive to indicate that the amounts that we are going to be putting on this supplier invoice, or sort of in this supplier journal, they are inclusive. They've got a VAT in it. And then the last thing that we need to set up is the referencing. How do you want this referencing to be? Do you want it to increment, or we don't want it to increment? Remember, it's only one supplier invoice that will be processing here. It's got only one invoice number. It means we should not increment. So we are going to say no. So once we are done with this, we can close. But just to recap, make sure that there is no contra account. Make sure that it's this year's processing. Make sure that you activate tax processing, and then you also activate 01, standard rated tax. And then your default entry type of your tax, check your invoice to see if the amount were exclusive or inclusive. So in this case, the amount are inclusive. So that's the situation there. So I'm going to close. And then the second step is to make sure that you are in the correct period. You can see, as we know, that we are processing in period one. So this is the correct period. We are fine with this. I'm going to press tab on my keyboard. And then I'm going to indicate the date. When am I buying from CompuWorld? I'm buying on the 20th. So I'm going to put the 20th there. Then I activate the supplier that I'm buying from, which is CompuWorld. And then I put in the reference. The reference will be your source document number that is appearing on page 10. So it's going to be CW20. So that will be your invoice number or your reference number. Then you need to indicate what is it that you bought. So it's going to be two Epson projectors, and then you must indicate how much are they each. So you're going to say at 4,999 each. Okay, at 4,999 each. Okay, so now you need to make sure that the tax that you're activating here is correct. So if you are buying an asset, as you can see, projectors are the assets of the business. So it means that your tax for assets will be tax 05. So when we buy the asset, the tax that we activate, it will be a tax 05. So once you have done that, you press a tab, you'll see that your cursor will jump to the inclusive amount. Why is that? It's because of your setting here. So the inclusive amount, you have to put in the total amount that you bought for, which is 998,000. So that is the total amount. Then you press tab. Then it's going to require the contra account. So the contra account, you must check in your account structure that you are given in the question paper. In this case, which is on page 8. On page 8, we have to now check which account are we going to use as a contra account when we are buying these Epson projectors. So what do we have there? We do have a computer equipment, which is account 6250,000. That is the main account. Then we have to activate account 6250/010, which is the computer equipment at cost. So we can get in there. And then we can type in, the account that we want to activate, 6250. And then we can select the computer equipment at cost. You cannot record in the main account, but you will record in the sub account called computer equipment at cost. So you can double click. So once you have done that, it means you are done with your first line. As you can see, account that was activated was the supplier account. And then do not forget to put your contra account there. If you don't put the contra account in the final exam, you are going to lose a mark there. So make sure that you put your contra account for each and every line that you are going to put here. So to continue, with the second line, the period is still fine, the date is still fine. We activate account CompuWorld. And then the reference is still fine, but now we need to put a new description. What did we buy? Is 5 Canon cartridges. And then you must indicate how much was each. It means it was 299,99 each. This is important for when we have to do the return. So we need to know how much was each of those cartridges. So Canon cartridges, what are the cartridges in the business? Cartridges in the business are normal expenses of the business. So we are going to activate tax 01 there because it's a normal expense of the business. And then how much is the total that we are going to put there is 1149. 95. Okay, then you are going to tap. Remember, you have to put in the contra account. It means you must go back to your account structure that you are given on page 8, and then you must look for the stationery or printing and stationery account. You can see that account there. You can just zoom in. That account, according to page 8, is 4,200 is printing and stationery. Then you must press enter there. Then we are now going to do the last line. Again, the period is correct. The date is still the 20th. The supplier is still CompuWorld. And then the reference is still the same. But now we need to indicate what we are buying. In this case, it's one Canon scanner. And then what is Canon scanner in the business? Is an asset of the business. It's going to stay with the business for a period of time. So It means our text here, it must now change to capital goods. So you can type 05 or you can scroll and select 05 there. Then the under inclusive amount, we can put how much we paid, which is 1,199.99. Then tap to the contra account. We need to activate which account will be affected when we buy the Kenno scanner. Again, we can check on page 8 on the structures of our account. You can see that we can still put this under computer equipment. Okay, we can still, so it means it's going to, we zoom in, it's going to be account 6250, and then is the computer equipment at cost. So once we have done that, it means you are done with this supplier journal where you are buying the non-stock items. So we need to print our supplier journal. How do we print it? We go to print and we print with contrast. Print and print with contrast. Remember, I don't have a printer. I'm printing on PDF. It's okay. Then I'm going to put in the name of this supplier journal. So I'm going to call it supplier journal 2. Remember, the supplier journal 1 was the take on balances. So I'm going to call this one supplier journal 2. So then I will save. And then I will check how will it look like when it's printed. Can I just open there? This is how it's going to look like. See, your ID number or your student number is there, your date, your period, the name of the supplier you're buying from, CompuWorld, your reference, which is on your original invoice, and also the description of what you're buying. And importantly, the tax that you applied for, or asset you applied 05. For normal expenditure of the business, you applied 001. And the amount were included in the, or were inserted in the exclusive column, or sorry, inclusive column. And then the most important part is to make sure that you put your contra account. So this is how it's going to appear, and this is how we are going to print it. So going back to this one, we just printed it. It's still on the screen. How do you check if this is correct? The total there at the bottom, which is 12,347.94, must be exactly the same as what is appearing on your question paper. Just double check that. The total there on the question paper is the same as this one. So it means if these two agrees, it means that you are correct. So you can just check at the end of your question paper to see if anything was required from you, but apparently only you're supposed to print this supplier journal. So now I'm going to deal with the return of the same supplier, which is on page 12. So as much as we have purchased, we also had to return some items. So where do I do the return? I do the return in the supplier allowances journal. So I'll just open the suppliers allowances journal. Remember, the first thing that you must do is to do what? Is to do your settings. Your settings, contra account, you should not put any. This year's processing, this is fine. And then a default text type, you can make it 01. And then remember the entry method. Our amount were inclusive, so you must select inclusive there. And then the referencing must not increment. It must say no here. So this is the setting that is important that you need to do there. So I'm going to close. Then I have to make sure that the period is right. Then I press tab. I need to put in the date of this return, which is the 25th. Then I press tab. Then I activate the supplier that I'm returning to, which is CompuWorld. And then I put in the reference. Remember, the reference will be your original invoice number. In this case, it's CW20. And then under description, I have to indicate what is it that I'm returning. So I'm returning two Canon cartridges. And what's wrong with them? It's wrong color. It's wrong color. You indicate there. The problem is wrong color. So if you look at the Canon cartridges, what is it in the business? It's a normal expense of the business. It's a normal expense of the business. So the tax that is going to be charged is going to be 01. Then from there, you move your cursor to inclusive amount. We need to make a calculation because we are returning two Canon cartridges and each of them cost 299. So you can use F9 on your keyboard to activate the calculator, and then you say 299.99 multiply by 2, because there were two Canon cartridges that were returned. So it's going to be 599.98. So this is the amount that you're going to put here, 599.98. Then you tap to the Contra account. What Contra account are we supposed to put in there? Remember, this was printing and stationery account 4,200. So I'm going to select that account. So that was the only return to Canon that was done. So it means we are done with this one. So what did we do? We made sure that the settings are correct before we start processing, and we made sure that the period is right, and then we indicated the date of the return, we activated the account of the supplier, we've put in the reference number, and then we put in a description with the reason why we are returning. We took note of the tax, as tax 01 for the normal expenses of the business, and we calculated the amount to be put here, which is 299.99 multiplied by 2. And then the last item was to make sure that we activate the Contra account, the other account that will be affected by this transaction. So what do we do now? We have to print with Contras. Every time we print a journal, we print with Contras. So I'm printing to the PDF. I'm going to save this as the supplier allowances journal. Okay, so I'm going to save that. I can just go in there to check how it's going to look like when it's printed. This is how it's going to look like. You can see your ID number again there, the date and the period, the name of the supplier, the reference, the reasons for your return, the tax, the amount under inclusive column, as well as the Contra account. So this is how you will process your non-stock items when you are purchasing them. You will process them through the supplier journal, and then when you return them, you will have to process the return through the supplier allowances journal. Thank you very much. This is the end of our lesson. If you find this video helpful, please like my videos and subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss when I post new videos.